rickety clack along main lines, rickety track.
She whispers softly in my ear,
just to say your last name.
Just find a place to make a set to keep easy.
That's just the way it is.
Sit down, see when things could only get better.
Yet the same in so many ways.
I have no recollection of the last time I came here.
But if we get much closer, I could lose control. And if your heart surrenders, you'll need me to hold.
I wouldn't be myself without you. Take a piece, take a picture of me. I don't care what happens, see, 'cause I know I'm happy.
Hello, everybody, and welcome once again to Kandu Arts for Sustainable Development's Open Mic for Open Minds. My name is Brian Reid, and this is episode 105, and 105 even. Crikey, where to start? I mean, everybody's talking about two black millionaires having a contretemps in public, okay? And I'm really not interested. Will Smith, Chris Rock, grow the hell up. Okay? And I'm not condoning what Will Smith did. Okay? And he's actually betrayed by his own actions, because he actually laughs at the joke that, however poor taste it was, that Chris Rock does regarding G.I. Jane about his boy. But Chris Rock, you know, when you make jokes about another man's wife in public, treading a bit of a tightrope, okay? I mean, there's some guys out there, they'll punch you if you look funny at their missus, let alone say anything even slightly derogatory, okay? So, you know, there's a little bit of knowingness which is involved here, which is where Chris Rock and the other comedians and other people out there, you know, the difference is, okay, is that, you know, I mean, if you've really sort of got your head screwed on, you know, taste is like indefinable. I mean, like, I got no issue with Will Smith or his missus getting ripped in public, okay? But I don't see how taking the mickey out of a woman's hair loss, when that is so tied up in her whole image and the whole cross that they have to bear, the female beauty situation that we've got going on in our society, all right? That, you know, you're really travelling in sort of dangerous waters, you know, where feelings run high, okay? And sadly for Will Smith, you know, all of his pronouncements about, you know, violence solves nothing, what have you. Sometimes people need a slap. And the question is you've got to choose the right moment, right? And I don't think 50 million people watching on TV is a good time to slap somebody, because everybody's seen what happened. And now everybody's talking about it. But hey, there's a real war going on. There's people, you know, just a couple of thousand miles away who are throwing massive munitions at each other. There are innocent people dying. And we're worrying about two guys who will never have to work another day in their life and will always be comfortable, okay, just like sort of slightly losing the plot. And that's really sort of quite an interesting representation of exactly what Hollywood represents. Okay, I mean, it's the biggest, like, sort of glitziest trade union in the world, where nobody's actually wants to be involved with the union. Okay, and they want to be united, but they don't want to be unionized. And that's an important description, because, like, obviously everybody in America knows that all union members are communists. All right, but apparently, you know, all the actual communists, or the people who call themselves communists, who were busy waging war, they're apparently acceptable partners in any sorts of business, okay? And we're giving them a hard time. But But the actual communists, you know, the ones that want to change our way of life, which has done so much for so many people, not. Okay. It's a bit difficult to work it out, really, isn't it? You know, up is down, black is white, brown is yellow. And nobody really sort of understands the level to which black people are judged on every little thing that they ever do forever. Okay, and everything that you do which is negative, all right, is used to confirm the bias of the people, okay, who think that you're less than human because of your skin colour. All right, so there are all sorts of horrific acts out there that are being done. You know, the Russians, people are using thermobaric weapons, which in case you weren't aware, thermobaric weapons are stuff that basically you drop a bomb over a place and inside the bomb is full of like stuff, gasoline and what have you, which actually permeates the air. All right. And then there's a secondary explosion, which then ignites that fuel, which means the whole area where that bomb drops and goes up to 5,000 degrees. So people just get cauterized. They get completely burnt out. And even if you're like not in the immediate center part, but in the secondary place, you organ damage, but the pressure, everything, it's just horrifying. Just look up thermobaric weapons and see what they do, and I guarantee you your blood will run cold. And this is what has been unleashed on the people of Ukraine. All right. While the Tory party in this country are still pretending that they didn't have any Tory parties all the way through the lockdown. All right. And that the police are just about to show and about to start issuing fixed penalty notices. Great, isn't it? We live in a country where you can get a fixed penalty notice for having a party. Behave. I mean, this is the land where raving started. Okay, this is the land where we ran around the country all over the place at all kinds of hours, dodging the police, getting to a place where we could party. Okay, because people love to party. All right. We knew that we were going to be in trouble, but we didn't care because we wanted to party. The difference is that we're not government ministers or civil servants or highly paid members of the Tory establishment. Okay, who obviously, you know how to party. So we'll see what happens with that. But you know, that every around us, everywhere we go, there's nothing but hypocrisy and rubbish. All right, or as I would say, bull crap. Okay, but yeah, it's good to be here. It's good to be on the set again for another show. All right, and I can't wait to see what you lovely people have got for us this week. Okay, so without further ado, take it away, you amazing open micers.
Thank you. love you for a thousand more. Because it's just been written. So I went to Stonehenge 2 weeks ago on the Friday that it was pouring with rain mm-hmm. and had big winds. And I'd never seen the Stones in that light. So when I got home, I read this piece, Stonehenge. In howling winds and driving rain, the standing stones looked on. Megaliths from another age, sleeping beauties on nature's stage, greenly rising from winter's plains, weeping ancients with blood-like stains, and man, just here, then, gone. This next piece, Bullying, I wrote for my children and grandchildren, because bullying never stops, it just changes. Bullying. Spite in the playground, spite on the net, spite and bullying at the same time, yet where does it come from? Does it come in the night? Is it born with the babe, the mother's delight, pouring onto the page in the light? Nasty and evil it creeps from the soul, causing real harm, the internet troll. Do they realise at all the damage it does? How it chips at the edges, nibbles at the mind, turning sane to insane. The bobbin rewinds. The shuttle is slowing. I think you will find the spiteful word worm is spiralling inside. Ignore them, dear. Doesn't stop the depression, doesn't stop the spite, making a dark impression. Some will survive, some will die, some will live with a damaged mind. So stop the bullies, stop the spite, listen to your children, make sure they're all right, talk with them.
Just wishing I could be alright. Just wishing. Long walk of the day, I and I met a little girl and she stopped.
Okay, so if you're looking at my ugly mug, that means we've come to the end of another show. How fabulous to have had so many people contributing to the open mic this week. Thank you to everybody that continues to show us love and to co-op and to get involved in our little initiatives. Thank you to everybody that has helped us to raise a few quid for Ukrainian medical supplies, and just keep on doing what you're doing, people. All right, because what we're doing is in a fine tradition of people all over the years finding their own way to entertain themselves, okay, when times are rough. But it's been an absolute pleasure being part of this, and I hope we continue for a long time. But right now, all right, I want you to give it up for my good man, Mr. Ed Deedigan. Take it away, Ed. Oh, and if you'd like to contribute to our diversity and our portfolio of performances, then you can do so by sending your contribution to openmic@kandu-arts.com. That's openmic@kandu-arts.com, and we will take note. Thanks very much. Now you can take it away, Ed. Bye bye. I could never.
you know my